Annie, first of all, what was it like this weekend facing, a little bit tougher competition? And I know you guys struggled towards the end. What was the difference in those three games than when you first started out?
I think it was a lot more exciting, but a lot more pressure put on us because I think it really tested how good we are. I mean, we were undefeated, but we weren't playing top level team. I mean, we were playing good teams, we were playing good competition, but nothing like Notre Dame and Florida State. And I mean, we faced Player of the Year, so it's definitely a different caliber of play. But I think it just tested us and showed us what we really need to work on.
Endurance wise, how much was that a test as well? Just with such a young team going for so long over the weekend.
I think it was definitely a test. I mean, we don't have that much depth on our team right now. We have kind of a small team this year, so it's definitely going to put pressure on the first team to go out there and be able to play five games a weekend. And I mean, the people off the bench did a really good job coming in and helping us out. We needed it. But I think people are going to get to see how hard it is once season starts happening, and it's every single weekend nonstop. So I think it was a good test for us.
Annie, you mentioned that the weekend kind of showed you guys some of the things you need to work on. What are some of those things right now?
Maturity, definitely. Like she already asked me a question about endurance-wise, emotionally, physically, everything. I mean, we have a lot to work on as a team, mostly in the mental stage, I think, because we are so young. A lot of physical things, too. I mean, coming and getting ground balls, like just the basic things that we need to work on, steals, first and thirds, things like that. But I think the most that we need to work on is our mental state and how we come to the field every single day ready to play and who's going to show up and who's not. I mean, you can't have two people show up and 16 people not show up. So definitely our mental game we need to work on.
What is it like for you as a player? I mean, I know you guys are supposed to play Tuesday and not with the weather. Is it hard to kind of adjust to that when you think you're going to play one day and then you're not?
Not really. Our coaches do a very good job of preaching, like, be ready for change. I mean, we always joke when our practice time gets changed, and, like, Karen's always like, you have to be ready for change. Like, you da-da-da-da. So I think we do fine with it. I mean, it's a little too cold to go outside, so I don't mind practicing inside instead of playing.
What's it like working with this pitching staff? Are you guys getting used to them?
Oh, yeah. It's really fun. I mean, they all are so different, so it's a challenge for Lexi and I. I mean, every time I catch Aaron, Rainey will come back in, and Aaron's a rise ball pitcher, and Rainey's a drop ball pitcher, so it just gives me some more motivation to stay focused because they're all so different. And, I mean, Gretchen throws, like, 75 miles an hour, and then you got drop balls and change-ups and rise balls. So, I mean, it keeps us on our toes. But I think with our staff being so different that it's going to do really well for us in the season.
What's the dynamic like for players like you and Rainey, who you a primary defensive position as a catcher, catching three players, also a primary hitter on the team. And Rainey, she's a pitcher and one of the team's leading hitters. Is it difficult at all to kind of balance those two big
roles? It definitely is difficult. I mean, I know I feel for Rainey. She goes out and plays right field every single game and has to get called in like in the middle of an inning, so, and she has to hit, so I know that has to be a lot for her. And I mean, like I said, it keeps me on my toes. I have to be mentally focused the entire game. I can't take one pitch off because every single pitcher is so different. I could go catching five rise balls on my toes to Rainey drop ball. So I mean, it's difficult, but I think Rainey definitely steps up to the challenge. I mean, she's so versatile and she has so much stuff going on that I don't even know how she does it.
For Rainey especially, she's already pitched, I think, half as many innings as she did all of last season, and we're still in February.
Yeah.
How is she doing with that increased workload in the circle?
I think she's doing great. I think this year she's coming out there ready to pitch. I think she knows that we need her. And, I mean, last year we had pretty much a set rotation with Ellen, and, I mean, we knew Ellen was going to throw. Now I think Rainey's really embracing the fact that we need her every single game to come in relief or to start or do whatever. So I think she's embracing it really well, and she's doing a great job. So,
and I know you talked about it being a challenge for you as a catcher, going from Gretchen, who throws hard, and maybe, you know, other pitchers who have a rise ball and Rainey's drop ball and whatnot. Well, has that been keeping opponents off balance at all? Has that been working like you guys would hope?
Yes, I think it does, especially when they're on. You know, I mean, it all depends whether or not the drop ball's moving, whether or not the rise ball's moving. But it definitely gives the hitters a different vision and a different plain to look at, because I know when we do it in practice, I'm like, oh god, how am I going to hit a rise ball and then have to go hit a drop ball? So going and playing against teams who have never seen our pitchers, I think it definitely throws them off a little bit.
Well, how mad are you just about being out in the 80s in the sun in California?
I know. I love the snow. I think it's really fun. It's cool. I mean, I never get snow at home, So it's cool for me, but it's just so weird going from 90 degrees to 19 degrees in a matter of hours. But, I mean, it's something that I embrace here. It's pretty fun.